What's going on YouTube? How's it going? And welcome back to the channel. It is your boy Cedric, and today we're jumping in with the free-to-play Crystal Hunter deck. Yes, guys, Rush Royale have gone ahead and nerfed Hunter Hex right into the ground, guys. It doesn't work at all. No chance at all. But I have just spent all my time, all my money on getting my Hunter to level 13 and getting them max talents on him, guys. So I thought I might as well try and make use of him. Crystal Hunter is still a massively OP duo. The Ivy in here is a massive combination killer, and the Ice Mage just to slow everything down and the Bombardier to stun things up is absolutely amazing, guys. You're going to be seeing exactly how we play it today. Basically trying to get a decent few Crystal Monsters on the board, so we are trying to get that high damage unit. Hunter's got the splash unit around him. Actually, I don't think I've got that talent on him today. I think I've got the extra crit on him, but obviously he's got the extra damage per shot, and he's just doing absolute bits. Every time we get them trophies, he's getting extra bits and bobs. So let's try and get everything on the board as much as we can. We've got a couple of cold mages there, another merge to Hunter there, so that's not too bad. And you can see everything's just going to be getting murked off as soon as it leaves my gate. Obviously, I know this is only round one, and we've only got Tamer coming up first, so it's nothing to worry about. But we are coming up against a greasy cultist deck, guys. He's got Frost in there himself, Ivy, Harley to copy things, and Portal Keeper to move things around. Let's just see if we can get the bread today, get the win, and get this game up and running, guys, because I am going away today. Don't worry though, I have plenty of videos recorded and ready to give to you all, keeping this YouTube channel going, keeping them all supplied for you. Supply and demand, guys. You want them, you got them. Let's keep on going. Alright, we've got plenty of slow on the board now. We've got two merge, two bombardiers, so that's looking good for us. Tamer coming up in just under 30 seconds. We are probably going to fill up our board, and we need to start concentrating on levels on things. Obviously, we don't need all of them there, and we do get the nice Mercury Crystal Mancer, so we're absolutely loving that one there, ladies and gentlemen. So we've got a decent bit of damage output with them. We want to get a few more Hunters and definitely a couple more Ivies on the board now, but obviously, we want to be starting to level up a couple of units. Well, obviously, we're not worried about Tamer. We're going to be taking them out even if all of our units are level 1. But you can see we really need to start getting some levels on all of our units, because we will be keeping things back even better once we go ahead and do that. That's not too bad for us, getting us the nice merge to Cold Mage there, and we get a little level on our Crystal Mancer as well. Taking Tamer out before he manages to spawn any of his monsters, any of his minions. So there we go, we get a second Ivy on the board there. We'll probably start merging things off, trying to get a few levels, a few higher leveled Ivies, trying to get a couple higher leveled Hunters as well, because they're the ones with the extra crit damage, taking things out as soon as they're leaving that gate. And look at that, Ivy's kicking in, Hunters are kicking in, Crystal's kicking in, Bombardier's stunning things up, and the Cold Mage slowing things down. Bunching it all together for that Hunters is absolutely what you like to see, guys. And boom, there you go, getting more trophies, taking them mini bosses out, and you can just see all of the crit coming off of everything. 11k. And it just slowed right down. 30k. Whoa, did you see that one? There we go. That's right. That's what you like to see. Obviously, he's only got the single T there at the minute. He's got two Mercury Portal Keepers, so he really wants to be getting them out of the way if he wants to try and get himself another T set up and running. He's got a Ivy there as well. Ooh, is he going to be able to get that second T up and running? We're going to have to wait and find out. Obviously, you can see things are slowly starting to build up out of my board. I can probably do with getting a couple more Crystal Mancers if at all possible. But you can see as we're leveling up our units, we are taking them back a little bit more. So that's not too bad for us. Just taking out this mini boss. Come on. And there we go. Getting another trophy on our Hunters there. So we're not worried about that one little bit. Oh, he slightly got the damage lead. His Ivy's doing nice bits for him. We've got Tribunal coming up. I only just realised that. That's not good. Oh, come on, let's see if we can get our board looking nice, ready for when Tribunal does come out. Hopefully we're not going to be taking out too much. We could really do with another nice merge through Crystal Mancer. That Bombardier is actually clutch as well, because that does give us the 2 and the 1, giving us the all-round 3, so we should be stunning most things up coming out of our gate now. Snowflake kicking in nicely there, so we do take our wave back quite a bit. And let's just see if we can get a couple of levels on our Crystal. Obviously, we are going to be getting taken out, which is kind of hurting a little bit, and he doesn't hit us all that bad, guys. Whoa, he got hit harder than what we do. That's what you like to see, his T getting taken out completely there, and we're back up and running with a couple of Crystal Mancers. I thought three Hunters leveled up then, but no, they didn't. That was just as I merged them. Obviously, the two did merge up. We got ourselves a nice merge, three Cold Mage out of that, a couple of decent merged Ivies now. So you can see we're going to be keeping things back just a little bit better. Is he going to be taking his out? No, he gets the hit there. That's very unfortunate, mate. Let's see if we... Oh, another Tribunal. Come on. Oh, he gets his T back there. Lucky for him. Let's just see. We've got plenty of slow on the board now. We've got that merge 2 Bombardier, so we've still got a little bit of stun. We could do with getting the Mercury Crystal Mancer back, guys, but Yes, you can see we're kind of keeping things back a little bit better than what he is now. That's exactly what we like to see. Let's see if we're going to be making it to another boss round, or let's see if we can overrun him in this round and get that dub, ladies and gentlemen. And if you haven't noticed, this deck is all free to play. Oh yes it is. There's no legendaries in here, guys. It's the classic Crystal Hunter free to play legendary killer, ladies and gentlemen. Look at us taking out this cultist. I know he's not completely set up, guys, but I don't know how he managed to do it. I don't know how he messed up so bad and he got the merge 3 portal keeper stuck there in that center position. But we're looking good, guys. We've still got that one empty tile for when Tribunal does decide to come out, if he decides to come out, shall I say. But let's just see if we can keep our going. Let's see what we can get merged off now, so we do get that tile empty and free once again. Not really a lot that I want to be merging off, but oh, look at that. We're back with the merge 3 Crystallmancer now, guys. That's exactly what we wanted, and there we go. That's the victory that we like to see, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get on through this. Getting a gold map for that as well. Come on. Let's get farming. Jumping into another one straight away for you guys. Woo! Taking out that cultist deck is absolutely beautiful. Let's see who we're going to be coming up against this time. Let's see what we're going to be coming up against next. It is the all-legendary deck. Blade Dancer, Bruiser, Inquisitor, Boreas, and Dryads in there. We're dropping a couple Bombardiers and a couple of Cold Mage, so we can't murder that at all. But let's just see how our all free-to-play deck plays out against his all-legendary deck then, shall we, ladies and gentlemen. Let's just see how we can get going. Get it up and running. Gorgon coming out first, so it shouldn't be too much to worry about. We will be filling our board up nicely for when he does decide to make an appearance. So let's just hope he can't get set up. Obviously, his Inquisitors are very number-dependent. If he doesn't have the 1, or the 4, or the 7, or the 10... they're all not going to be doing as much damage as possible. Again, if he gets his Blade Dancers connected, they're not going to be doing as much damage as possible. Boreas is not got any talents on it, so they're not going to be doing amazing without any Hex or anything next to them. Bruiser, if he can't get any decent merge Bruisers on the board, they're not going to be doing too much damage if they can't get enraged and if they're all sleeping on the job. So I'm feeling pretty confident now, guys. Don't get me wrong, his legendaries have all got a heck of a lot higher damage output than what we have, but our board is filling up there, and you're going to be seeing us keep our way back just a little bit nicer now. Ivy's doing their job. Hunter's starting to kick in. Cold Mage slowing everything down. That singular Crystallmancer is our almighty damage dealer right now. Let's just see if we can get a little bit more on the board, start merging things up, getting a few levels on things, and then we'll be taking Gorgon out fairly swiftly, I can imagine. And as you can see, he's only got the 2 merge 1 Inquisitors there, so they are switched off as I told you they would be. And let's just keep on going, getting ourselves a merge 2 there, so we get that merged into the crit tile, knowing that it was going to be a cold mage, because that's just Rush Royale all over for you guys. You can predict the randomness, eh? Get a load of that. You can predict the randomness. But anyway, we do get ourselves a nice merge 2 Crystallmancer there, guys, so that's exactly what you like to see. Getting another Cold Mage there, so we can get those two merged down into the corner. Getting ourselves a nice merge 2 Hunter as well. So let's just keep on going, keep on dealing that damage, and that's exactly what we like to see. Getting a couple of levels on things, and we will be taking Gorgon out pretty much instantly, guys. And he's got he's got a couple of Blade Dancers connected there, so that's a little bit worrying for him. He takes them out pretty swiftly though, and we do manage to take ours out. Getting a merge up on our Hunters there, which is absolutely beautiful. And then we got another Gorgon coming out, so let's just see if we can hold on now. 24k, 24k, look at all the crits coming from me, boy. That's what we like to see, taking this all legendary deck out, driving it down hard into the ground. Come on, let's keep on dropping. Let's get these last couple of tiles filled. We get another couple of Ivies there, so let's get merged up onto that attack tile for another Hunter. That's what we like to see. Getting another Cold Mage there, so we'll get a couple of levels on there, and they'll be slowing things down for us. And now we want to get a couple more higher level merged Crystallmancers. That would be absolutely ideal for us. That's what would be beautiful. But you can see we're just concentrating our levels now, concentrating our banner on doing that damage, getting the work on the go. We get another merged 2 Bombardier there, so everything's going to be getting stunned up pretty nicely now, so I can't be moaning at that. Getting those Ivies merged up there. I don't want to be losing all of my Ivy power. It's a little bit unfortunate. We do get the merge 2 back there. Merging the 2 merge 1s up. We've got another Cold Mage there, so it's a little bit more slow for us. Not that we really needed it, guys. Look at our board. It's absolutely beautiful. We could do with a couple more Crystallmancers, don't get me wrong. We have got a decent high level on them. They are level 4. We're going to be getting a couple of levels on our Bombardiers as well as soon as we can do. There we go. Getting them up to a level 3 there as well. So just under 30 seconds now until Gorgon's coming out. I'm feeling pretty confident that I'm going to be taking him out pretty much instantly, guys. Getting that last tile filled up with a merge one crystal mancer, so we get them merged up for another bombardier, guys. Let's get a couple of them merged off, and we get another mercenary hunter. So that's just DEM mage upon damage. So we're looking very nice now. You can see we have slightly taken the damage lead there. He's starting to struggle. He's got his four inquisitors there, one in a merge three. He's got two blade dancers, so all of his bruisers are sleeping. They're asleep and they're not doing the damage output that he needs them to, but now as we go into this boss round, obviously they're going to switch on and I'm sure he'll take this boss out pretty quickly, guys. But we get the stun off and we're going to be taking our Gorgon out very, very quickly there. And he's not taking his out as quickly as what I thought there. Unfortunately for him, we're looking good in this one, guys. Oh yes, we are. All legendaries are standing up to my amazing Crystal Hunter free-to-play deck. It's the right variant. Don't need Hex no more, guys. They've nerfed him into the ground. Get yourselves Crystal Hunter and the free-to-play beauties that are here. Bombardier, Cold Mage, and Ivy. So we get a couple of them merged up. We do get the nice merge three Frost or Frost Cold Mage down onto that attack tile there. So he's going to be slowing things right down for us. We've got all the damage on there with our Hunter. You can see we've got a merge four down in there in the corner. That's very nice for us. If one of them do get leveled up with the trophies, well, the merge 2, basically, we'll probably get a couple of merge 3s merged off, see what we can get out of that, see if we can get something else that's on the board that's a nice, going to be a nice merge 4 for us. But we're going to be getting our last level on our Crystal Mancer there. You can see nothing's basically making it out of our gate, out of our portal. You can see all of the Bombardiers are stopping them. All the Cold Mages are slowing them down, grouping them together, and the Hunter Crystal Mancer duo, the combination is just doing absolute bitch, taking them out. And we do get another merge 2 there, so we'll get them merged down there for a merge 3. We'll probably get a couple of them merge 3s merged off now because we don't really need all of them. We do get the merge 4 Bombardier out of that, so we've got the 1, 2, 3, 4 Bombardier. Not that we need all of them, so we'll get a couple of them merged up, get the merge 2, so we'll get that one merged up. And we do get another merge 3 Cold Mage there, ladies and gentlemen. So that's just so much slow, and it's all stacking. Bedlam is coming out in 4, 3, 2, 1. He's most probably definitely going to be getting the switch off on me. 1.2 million. Yes, I highly anticipate that he will be getting the switch off on me. I'm sure that we'll get the switch off on him as well, though. I know. Yes, he does. He leaves him with an uneven amount of Inquisitors there, so we're looking good. He's done a bit of work to us. He's left us with a couple of Crystal Mancers, so we can't moan at that one there. Taking him down quickly. I'm pretty sure we're going to be taking him out as soon as he does make his way around. We've been nice there with the merge 4 Crystal Mancer, merge 4 Cold Mage there, so we're slowing things right down with that. We still got the Mercury Hunter on that attack tile, two Mercury Ivies, and we still got the Mercury Bombardier for all of that stun. Not look bad at all. He's got a decent amount of bruises there. He has got a decent amount of Boreas. Two Blade Dancers, two Inquisitors. He's not looking terrible, guys, but we're looking beautiful. Oh, yes, we are. Bedlam coming out again in 45 seconds. So let's just see if we can finish this game and get that dub before he makes an appearance, shall we, guys? Let's just keep on going. All of our units are looking at decent levels. We've got some decent mana coming around now. We should be taking this Vortex out pretty quickly, getting another level on our Hunter there. Come on, let's get him taken out, guys. As soon as we take him out, you can see our board is coming around very slowly. Cold Mage putting in the work, putting in the damage, and he does just get his fourth Inquisitor there, so he's going to be putting out a little bit extra work there. But is he going to be able to catch up? Is he going to be able to bring it back? I don't think so. Our board is starting to build up a little bit. We're starting to fall off a little bit with the damage output. Come on, we just need a couple units to make it through. There's that Speedy Gonzalez. He's had to drop his ability there. We've got our ability if we do need to go ahead and drop her. Things are coming around pretty quickly. I don't know if I'm going to be able to take this Vortex out. And ooh, I didn't realize how close we were to Bedlam. That's pretty scary. He's going to be switching us all over the place. He gets switched up as well. We get the stun off though, so we're doing a decent decent bit of damage. Oh, we get nice again with the two merge 4 Crystal Mancers there. Let's just see if we can do a decent amount of damage and get this guy taken out. Come on. Is he going to be taking his out? I don't think so. Not at 800k. And yes, he doesn't take his out. So that's all right for us. Let's just see if we can actually do a decent bit of work to this and take ours out. 1.7, 1.6. He's going down fairly slowly. We didn't really get nice there with Crystal Mancers, unfortunately. Ooh, I don't think we're going to be taking ours out either. He's coming around that corner at 800k. That's a lot of Bombardiers and not a lot of Crystal Mancers at all. We get the merge 4 Crystal Mancer there, so that's not terrible. Is it going to be enough to take him out? That's the question. I think we are going to be taking him out. We took ours out. Yes. So we're going into this next round with three hearts. He's only got the singular one. Let's see if we can get that bread, get that dub, hold on this final round. That merge four bombardier is going to be putting in the work, stunning things up all over the place for me, as is the merge four cold mage there. He's going to be slowing things right down. Just enough damage to be holding on in there, guys. Come on, we can get this bread now. He's only got the singular heart. I don't think he can stop it. He's going to have to drop his hero once again. Should we be able to take this vortex out? We've got our ability still if we need to use it. If we do need to go ahead, but he's not taking his out. And we get the victory there, guys. That's exactly how you do it with the new Crystal Hunter free-to-play combination. Screw Hex, guys. He's out of here. He's no good with Hunter anymore. But this is the free-to-play combo you need to be taking out all of them legendaries. Leave a like if you have enjoyed the video, guys. Subscribe if you are new around here. Plenty more Rush Royale for you to enjoy on the channel. And I'll see you all in the next video. Peace!